Welcome to my short video on testing the throttle body on the bench. Hope it helps you. The blade won't swing to the open position with just the ignition on when you press the accelerator pedal. The engine needs to be running for the ECU to send that message. The throttle body has six pinouts, letters A to F. If you look closely inside the socket, you can see them. To bench test, you are going to need a 12 volt and 5 volt DC power supply. An old PT80X power supply does this well. All black wires are ground, yellow wires are 12 volts, and the red wires are 5 volts. To trigger the power supply to come on outside of a PC, you need to jump the green wire to any black wire as shown. The wiring schematic shows each outlet function. A and B being the blade drive motor. C to F are for the two TBS throttle position sensors. I have connected two multimeters to show the readings for both the TBS. Obviously, you only need one multimeter to do these tests one at a time. I've included a switch to the 12 volt motor supply so that I can control its opening and closing operation. Setting up the first multimeter connected between D and ground, and the second multimeter connected between F and ground, we can monitor both TPS voltage outputs as the blade moves. Don't switch the 12 volt motor supply on to start with. The 5 volt supply should be on. This will show that the TPS voltage readings with the blade in the fully closed position. You would expect to get 3.7 volts and 1.4 volts or thereabouts. Now switch on the 12 volt motor supply, just long enough to see the voltage readings with the blade fully open position. You would expect to get 4.5 volts and 0.5 volts or thereabouts. Basically, one TPS increases in voltage while the other decreases. If the throttle body is showing the appropriate voltage changes and the blade is swinging fully, then you have to assume there isn't much wrong with the throttle body.